Dear students, in last video you know the meaning of some basic concepts of chemistry, and in this video I explaining laws of chemical combinations. These laws are very important concepts in this chapter. Let us see about each laws. Laws of chemical combinations: law of conservation of mass, law of definite proportions, law of multiple proportions, Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous volumes, and Avogadro law. Let us see about first law, that is law of conservation of mass. This law was put forth by Antoni Lavoisier. The statement of law, it states that matter can neither be created nor destroyed, or the mass of the products in a chemical reaction must equal to the mass of the reactants. For example, burning of wood, there the release of the carbon dioxide gas, C plus O2 is equal to CO2. In this reaction, the mass of the product is equal to the mass of the reactant, that is 44 gram. And the law of conservation of mass is useful for a number of calculations and can be used to solve for unknown masses, such as the amount of gas consumed or produced during a reaction. This law of conservation of mass in chemistry: when you build fire during a camping trip, you pile up cut logs and some kindling and set flame to it. As the fire continues, the logs burns until you are eventually left with a small amounts of ash and charred remains. What happened to our original logs? Did they just disappear? According to the law of conservation, the magnitude of properties within a chemical system, such as mass, energy or charge, remain unchanged during a chemical reaction. These properties may be exchanged between components of the system. However, the total amounts in the system does not increases or decreases. In our fire example, the burning wood is a chemical reaction. Wood is made up of mainly carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. When you burn wood, the heat from the fire breaks down the bond between the elements. Hydrogen and oxygen are released into the air, while the carbon is left behind as a char. The black material left behind after wood is burnt is mostly made up of carbon, because we cannot see the gases that were released during the burning process. The mass of the end products appears smaller, but if we were able to measure the mass of the released carbon and oxygen plus the mass of the remaining char, we would find that the mass of these end products would be the same as our original wood. The form of the matter may be different. They have been transferred from solid wood to the volatile gases and the char, but the total mass of the end products are the same as what we started with the first products. This is a law of conservation of mass. Next law is law of definite proportions. This law was given by Joseph Proust. The law states that a given compound always contains exactly the same proportion of elements by weight. It is sometimes referred to as law of definite composition. For example, a sample of carbon dioxide gas obtained from different sources, from vehicles or from burning of wood, that contain exactly same ratio by mass of carbon and oxygen. Mass of carbon is 12 divided by mass of the oxygen is 32. It forms 0.375 gram of the sea wood. And this law of definite proportions in chemistry: have you ever wanted to make more food than a recipe called for? Let's say you have a chocolate cake recipe that feeds your people. For example, that feeds 4 people, but you are going to a birthday party that will have 8 guests. You will need to double the recipe, which also means you will need to double the amounts of eggs, sugar, flour, butter, milk and chocolates for the recipe. The amount of each ingredients will double, but the proportions should stay the same. We can think about this principle. When defining the law of definite proportions, which states that any chemical compounds will always contain a fixed ratio of elements by mass. This is the law of definite proportions. Next law is law of multiple proportions. This law was proposed by Dalton. Statement of the law is, if two elements can combine to form more than one compound, the masses of one element that combine with the fixed masses of the other element, they are in the ratio of small whole number. In the given below example, hydrogen combines with oxygen to form two compounds. Those are mainly water and hydrogen peroxide. Here fixed mass of the hydrogen 2 gram react with the 16 gram of oxygen, it gives water, that is 18 gram. Next example, fixed gram, that is 2 gram of hydrogen, means fixed mass of the hydrogen, that is 2 gram, react with the 32 gram of oxygen, it forms hydrogen peroxide, means 34 gram of hydrogen peroxide. Law of multiple proportions in chemistry. We have a lot of food options because we love variety of food and we like to try the new things. Sometimes we like to try different combinations of our favorite things. Let's examine the pizza. Here the given below image is consisting of pizza. No, it has tomatoes, pepperoni, bell pepper, cheese, olives and mushrooms. Sometimes we like to double the cheese and like to double the pepperoni. There are other times when you don't feel like having a lot of mushrooms, so we just put it the half of the pizza. Now let's think about a nice classic breakfast item, which is the ham, egg and cheese sandwich. Sometimes we double up on the egg or we double up the cheese or the ham when we feel hungry. Sometimes we just eat half the sandwich if we are in a hurry. There are many possible combinations when it comes to food. Just like different combinations are possible in the food, different combinations are also possible for elements that make up compounds. Compounds are made up of atoms of different elements. There are compounds made up of same elements like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide. Both compounds are made up of the any other components. Means from this we concluded that two or more elements that combine to form the compounds, the masses of one element that combine with the fixed mass of the other element, they are in the ratio of small whole numbers, like food. The next law is Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous valley. This law was given by Gay-Lussac. The statement of law is, when gases combine or produced in a chemical reaction, they do so in a simple ratio by volumes, provided all gases are at same temperature and pressure. Example, 100 ml of hydrogen combines with 50 ml of oxygen to give the 100 ml of oxygen to give the 100 ml of the water vapor. Like this, this Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous volumes in chemistry. This explains about the relationship between the temperature and the pressure. It states that the volume of the container is held constant. As the temperature of the gas increases, the pressure inside the container is also increases. Last, that is Avogadro law. The law states that this law was given by Avogadro. Statement of law is equal volumes of gases at the same temperature and pressure should contain equal number of molecules. Whenever we fill the air inside the balloon, the volume of the balloon increases because the number of gas molecules inside the balloon is also increases. So volume of the balloon is also increases. Based upon this volume, the law states that here the equal volumes of gases at the same temperature and pressure should contains what? Equal number of the molecules. For example, 10 cm cube of chlorine is react with the 10 cm cube of H2. It gives 20 cm cube of the 2HCl. Thank you.